Hey everyone, it's Alex Martinez with realestateskills.com, and today we're covering how to get into real estate with no money. So I'm going to cover the strategy today that I use to get into real estate with no money, that my partners have used, that my students have used. As my business partner likes to say, this is not a get rich quick scheme. This is a get rich for sure plan. This isn't something that overnight you're going to make $1 million, but this is literally something in 2, 3, 4, 5 years, you can have $1 million net worth and you can start building financial freedom for yourself and have properties that are paying you every single month in real estate. You can do this with no money. That's how you get started. Of course, you'll be making money along the way, but also you can do this with no experience if you're starting today, and you can do this with no real estate license. I started with $30,000 in school debt about 10 years ago, and now I'm totally out of debt, right? We've done a lot of real estate deals. My partners and I, we own property in different parts of the country. And so we're going to cover exactly how you can do that, get started with no money. It was Steve Jobs that actually said, you can't connect the dots looking forward. You have to connect the dots looking backwards. So let's do that today as I map out what I call the evolution of a real estate investor. So let's start with this pillar over here, buying and holding real estate. All right. And for the sake of this topic today, let's talk about buying and holding single family houses. Now, what I want for everyone is to be able to have enough real estate single family houses that you own that are paying you every single month in passive income, because other people are living in your property, paying down your mortgage and paying you rent every single month. And this is how you can make money on the beach, sipping pina coladas, because you own real estate, all right? But it's hard to do when you're just starting out, when you're just getting started. How we do that is we're gonna break it down. We have the end in mind here, right? We wanna buy and hold real estate. Let's say 10 properties, you want that so they can pay you $5,000 per month, because each property you have is paying you $500 and you have 10 of them, right? That will bring you that passive income. And now if you double that, you have $10,000 a month. And so we need to work our way there. So how do we do that? All right, well, let's go to the next pillar. So fixing and flipping. And once again, we're connecting the dots as we look back. So fixing and flipping, a lot of us know what that is, right? You're buying property, houses, you're renovating them and reselling them for a profit, right? That's what you want to do when you fix and flip. But guess what? A lot of the times this takes money too. So how do we get started with no money? If our end goal is to buy and hold and have dozens of properties that pay us passive income every single month, how do we get there? Well, how I started, how a lot of people start, is actually with wholesaling real estate, okay? And I'd like to call this the evolution of a real estate investor, because you can evolve. If you start here, wholesaling real estate, and I'll get into this in just a second, exactly what this is. If you start here, guess what? You can then fix and flip property while wholesaling real estate, and you can roll your profits into buying and holding property. So once again, this is a long-term strategy, but you can get started today wholesaling real estate. So let's cover exactly what this is. Wholesaling real estate is when you actually put a house under contract to buy. Now, let's be very clear, you're not buying the property. All you do is put it under contract to buy. And guess what? That doesn't require any money, no money at all. So you can put a property under contract to buy, and guess who wants to buy these properties you put under contract? Fix and flippers. When you put a distressed house under contract to buy, it doesn't cost you any money, and then you can sell that for a profit to fix and flipper. So let's say you put under contract at $190,000 and you sell it to a fix and flipper at $200,000. You make the difference, that spread, $190,000 to $200,000, they'll pay you $10,000 for that deal. And now the reason why, because I know people ask me, well, why would a fix and flipper pay for a deal, right? Like, can't they find deals for themselves? Guess what? Fix and flippers, they're real estate investors and they're business owners too. So they're not only fixing and flipping property, they're hiring different employees. They're managing different projects. They may be running the marketing in their company, right? They're doing a lot of other things besides just finding deals. So when you can get a property under contract, a house that needs fixing up for a fix and flipper, they're gonna pay you this money, $10,000 per deal, because they're gonna make a profit on the deal. That's an important thing. They're gonna make $30,000, $40,000, or $50,000 of profit on that deal once they fix it up. But I wanted to start here because when I was about 19, 20 years old, I did my first deal, made $22,000 of profit from wholesaling a house. Got under contract at $328,000, wholesaled it to a fix and flipper, which we call a cash buyer, for $350. So the spread was $22,000, and it took about 8 hours of work on that deal. So it was about over $2,000 per hour. I forget all the math, but that's how I got started without any capital. So let's go ahead into wholesaling and talk about exactly what this is, and then we'll get into fixing and flipping and buying and holding, all right? So with wholesaling, what we need to do is find a property. And get it under contract, okay? Right, that's the action that we need to do. And why I'm telling you this today, why this is so important, like I said, I can connect the dots looking backwards. If you wanna be a successful fix and flipper, if you wanna be a successful buy and holder, so someone who owns a lot of real estate, well, you make your money when you buy, when you can find a great deal and get under contract. So if you get great at this skill set of wholesaling, of finding distressed properties and getting them under contract, guess what? Fixing and flipping becomes much more simple. You don't have to rely on anyone else but yourself to be able to find these deals. And then guess what? When you wanna buy and hold a dozen properties that pay you every single month of passive income, you know how to find the properties because you started here. You've cut your teeth with wholesaling and you've worked out how to analyze properties. What's a good deal? What's a bad deal? What else is great about wholesaling is that when you're selling a deal, you're selling this distressed property to a fix and flipper. So what does that mean? When you sell it to a fix and flipper, you have a relationship with this person. This fix and flipper knows general contractors in their area. They know how to manage a ton of successful projects. They know how to flip 2, 3, 4, 5 houses at a time. You can get started here and you'll start to develop key relationships that you need to be a successful fix and flipper. And when you can get paid on average, what we see across the nation, $10,000 per deal for wholesaling a property, every single deal we complete, it's like getting paid to learn. That's what I call it. Because you learn this transaction process, you learn about the best general contractors, you learn what it takes, how to fix the flip a property in your area, you're building relationships with potential key partners in the future, and it's invaluable. And this is very active, right? So I like to call this being an active real estate investor because you're actively working. You're in the trenches day to day. You're cutting your teeth doing this. You're learning the ropes. You're building relationships. You're getting paid to learn. So that's how we get started in real estate with no money. But I don't want to leave you hanging there, right? I want you to look into the future. I want to illuminate the path for you. I don't want everyone here just to wholesale property. I want you to be able to build the dream life that you want. I want you to own as many properties as you want. I want you to be able to pass these properties down to your children, build a legacy. I want you to not have to worry about, you know, your monthly bills every single day. I'd rather you worry about, hey, you know, my monthly bills are taken care of because I own so many properties and now I have this extra capital coming to me every single month. What do I do with this extra money, right? Those are bigger and better problems to have because now you can think about donating money to a charity. You can think about solving bigger problems in the world. You can put money away for your children to go to college, right? There's a lot of things you can do with the capital now and live a bigger and more impactful life. So once you nail wholesaling and understand this, once again, this is the perfect starting point to get into real estate with no money. Now you're building these relationships with fix and flippers. You're selling them deals. And just so we're all on the same page, you can wholesale one deal a month, 2, 3, 4, 5. I have students doing multiple deals per month, making anywhere from $10,000 to $100,000 a month doing this side of real estate, wholesaling real estate, okay? Now what you can do, right, on this evolution of a real estate investor is, let's just say you're doing 4 deals a month, all right? So you're making actually $40,000 a month because you're doing 4 wholesale deals a month. And let's say you've been doing this for a few months now. You built necessary relationships to fix and flip your first house because it's very important to have great general contractors to renovate the property for you. Because to scale a fix and flip operation, you can't be banging hammers all day and painting walls. You'll be stuck on one property at a time and it'll take 6 months or 3 months here and there. Instead, you work with general contractors and that allows you to work on multiple projects at a time because the general contractor will hire subcontractors out. And once again, you can work on multiple projects at a time. Now, once you've cut your teeth, you're developing a track record. You're building up a positive reputation for yourself in your community, in the real estate community, because you're wholesaling real estate. Now, what I want you to do is cherry pick the best deal, instead of wholesaling it, the best deal with the biggest amount of profit in there from analyzing the property, that is the least risky, so needs the lowest amount of repairs on it, that's the first deal that you want to do as a fix and flip, okay? So you want to cherry pick the best deals for yourself. Now, you may be saying, well, Alex, why don't I just start fixing and flipping property right away? Well, what's really important to understand is that fixing and flipping, you have to bring capital to the table. You can borrow money from other people to do this, but if you start with wholesaling, you're gonna have a track record of positive deals that you've sold to fix and flippers, and now the likelihood of you getting lent money to buy fix and flip property is so much higher, because you can say, hey, I did 12 deals in the last 90 days. I worked with this buyer here and this buyer and this buyer, and the lender's probably like, hey, I know all those people. You obviously know what you're doing. Your buyers can vouch for you, and now you can get lent money for these fix and flip deals. So that's one really great reason to get started with wholesaling. Another great reason is that you've now got experience. So there's a lot of people that want to get into fixing and flipping and buy a house for their first deal and get in way over their head, right? They think the house will need $30,000 in repairs, and guess what? It needs $60,000, and that eats directly into your bottom line. They think the house will sell at $500,000, but it sells at $450,000. That eats directly into your bottom line. They think the project will take 3 months, and guess what? It takes 8 months. And all that time, everything right there creates more risk for you. So fix and flip deals are inherently more risky. And I've seen a lot of people get in and out of this business because they skipped wholesaling. They didn't have a lot of capital, they had no money, but they wanted to fix and flip a deal, and it was more driven by their ego than really being a smart move for them in their life. So once again, when we can wholesale now fixing and flipping, we set ourselves up for success. We got paid to learn, we built the right relationships, and now instead of an average of about $10,000 per deal, remember right here, we did four deals, equals $40,000. Now you can make about $40,000 to $50,000 per deal. So you can get started in real estate with no money, start wholesaling houses every single month, and then you can cherry pick the best deals to fix and flip, but you've got your track record, you got experience, and so now the likelihood of you making money and being successful as a fix and flipper and as a wholesaler doing both at the same time is exponential. 10 times, 100 times more likely that you're gonna be successful and stay in this business and be on the evolution of a real estate investor. And once again, we started all of this with no money because we started wholesaling. Now what you can do, as you start wholesaling and fixing and flipping property every single month, you're gonna be building a nest egg of capital, of profit. So now once you build this nest egg of capital, guess what? You can buy and hold real estate. You can actually buy property outright. You can buy it with a loan, 20-25% down, but you can buy investment properties. And now this is a huge flywheel going on, and you've made money actively in real estate from wholesaling, fixing, and flipping. And all of this time it's taken you to do this because you've had to cut your teeth. Now you're gonna be able to find the best deals to buy and hold at the best price with the largest profit and the largest amount of cash flow, because you've worked your way up into that point. And so this is why it's important here to start with no money, right? We all wanna start here, and people get stuck. They're like, how can I buy and hold a property? You know, they're thinking about it for 2-3 years, and they never get started in real estate. They never start developing the skills that they need to be able to find deals and get deals below market value to make a profit or cash flow on them. So once you get to this point, and this may take 1 or 2 years now, right? You could start wholesaling. I've worked with people that have wholesaled their first deal in 2-3 weeks. But now to run a fix and flip operation, to grow into that, give yourself a couple years of building these relationships, of really honing down your systems and processes. Now you're gonna have this nest egg of capital. And now you can buy a property one every 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, 5 months. And let's just say in a few years, you now buy 5 properties, right? 5 props, they each cash flow $500 a month. Right, that's $2,500 a month. And now you're working your way towards financial freedom because you're getting that money passively. Right now, let's do 10 properties. That's $5,000 a month. Right, now let's do 20 properties. $10,000 a month, right? Now, a lot of people can live off this passive income. This is how you can, once again, be on the beach sipping pina coladas and get paid for doing it. It's how you can be able to get mailbox money every single month because you've bought and held property because you've learned these skill sets of what's a good property, you know, what's a bad property, because you've taken this path. And this is why it's not a get-rich-quick scheme, right? We're talking about years into the future. But it's the people that think that, hey, man, I need to have success in 90 days, 6 months, 12 months, right? I need to own all of these properties. Their expectations do not meet reality, and they get in and out of this business. And, you know, the next month they're onto affiliate marketing, you know, then they're drop shipping or doing whatever the heck they want to do, when really, real estate is one of the most stable and consistent industries in the world. There's people being born every single day. The population's always increasing, and people always need a place to live. They always need a roof over their head. And with the basic supply and demand of economics, there are more people being born every single day than there are houses built. So you know, if you invest into real estate, the appreciation, the price will always increase. It will always be a steady and consistent investment for you to where the price will always increase. It's just the basics of supply and demand. So when you follow this path, once again, you're in real estate, you're actively learning, and now you're putting your money back into real estate. It's this flywheel that's going to continue to work for you over and over and over again. And as I mentioned, wholesaling is when you're active, you're being an active investor. Now, fixing and flipping is really active too. Look at yourself on a day-to-day basis. You're running a business, you're running an operation, you're doing these things to make money. You're actively making money through real estate. But what's beautiful is that once you get to this point and you put money into here, it's passive. It's passive, it's passive, it's passive. And you keep working towards this, make money from wholesaling and fixing and flipping, put into buying and holding, you're gonna have this passive income for years to come. And you didn't have to learn a whole entire new industry. You didn't have to learn a whole entire new skill set. Just for years, you got better at real estate and you started with no money. So here's the blueprint. It's the evolution of a real estate investor. And remember, we began with the end in mind. But if we have no money and we want to get into real estate, that's why we start wholesaling. We gain track record, we gain credibility, we make an income, we cherry pick the best deals to fix and flip, and we've gained all these positive relationships because we've been wholesaling deals to fix and flippers. We know the best general contractors and everyone involved. And now we are eliminating risk because we know exactly what's a great deal, what's a bad deal, and you're able to make even more money by fixing and flipping while wholesaling. And then we're able to roll our nest egg into buying and holding real estate. Now, what I did for you, right? Because I call this the evolution of a real estate investor. I actually have a printout. I'll put it right here at realestateskills.com/EVO for evolution. If you type that in, you'll be able to get this printout of the evolution of a real estate investor. You can pin it up on your wall because it's important to have visual cues and visual reminders so you remember this. And this is not something you're gonna wanna forget and watch another YouTube video and, you know, 3 months later, now you're looking at this again, you're like, man, I should have started 3 months ago. Right? So this is something you can always remind yourself of and get started on this path, because whether you're in real estate, like you're actively in real estate, or you're thinking about getting into it, whether you make your money inside of real estate or outside, the wealthiest people put their money back into real estate, right? All roads lead back to real estate. So this is just an easy to see path in real estate on how to get started with no money, no experience, without having to have a real estate license that I followed, my students have followed, my partners have followed. And I wanted to share this with you because no one taught me this. Right, this is something from experience, from having to connect the dots myself and get all this information. But I want to put it in a very simple and concise manner so you understand it. And if you want to start with wholesaling, what I recommend is go to realestateskills.com/training. I actually made a training on exactly how to make $10,000 to $100,000 a month wholesaling houses. And you can do this with little to no capital, just like we're talking about. Be well on your way, like us and so many people are doing today in this day and age. You know, they always say the best time to buy real estate and get into real estate was 20 years ago. The second best time is right now. I believe that to be true. What I want to do, since we make a lot of content on all of this information on YouTube, I want to show you one of our best videos on wholesaling and show you a clip right here of how you can get started wholesaling in 21 days or less. Just to recap this, I want you to understand, if you want to wholesale your first house, don't expect to send one offer and get it under contract. Don't expect, you know, that you're going to be able to send one offer and wholesale that house. Okay. What I want you to understand is it typically takes about 15 offers sent, right? And offers, what we consider offer sent, is when we get the contract back from the agent, we send it back to them. So only the seller needs to sign it now. It takes about 15 of those to get one deal. I'm telling you this now so you have the right expectations, because most people are unhappy when their expectations do not meet reality. All right. So when people have the wrong expectations and they think they'll submit two offers, two contracts, get a deal, it ain't the case.
But if you say, man, I'm gonna listen to Alex, I'm gonna send one contract a day, and that is my goal, to get that contract back, to sign it, get it to the seller, so if we can keep on moving forward, one a day, you'll send 30 offers by the end of the month. And guess what? Something great is gonna come out of that. You are most likely going to get a deal. And if not, you'll be able to refine and learn so much more about this process. So probably in the next 2 weeks after that, you'll be able to get a deal.
So I hope you enjoyed that clip. We also got a lot of great other videos on how to find cash buyers for free online, the 8 do's and don'ts of wholesaling real estate for beginners. And then also we have the 5 reasons why most wholesalers suffer and quit, so you can avoid those pitfalls and become successful at getting started in real estate with no money. So I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you can, please like, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and leave a comment if you enjoyed this video. I'm looking forward to seeing your feedback and what you think. And once again, this is Alex Martinez with realestateskills.com. Hope you have an awesome day. Happy wholesaling and happy investing. Talk to you soon.